You know, I think this is a slide for those of you who have attended some of our in-person events over the last few years. This is not a new slide, actually. This is the three stages of digital transformation. And there was some joke circulating about, you know, whatever we have done in terms of trying to get this process going. It was COVID that fast-tracked really digital transformation in our society. Before going to the digital transformation, we have been looking at how to help companies, organizations at various stages to bring them there. There's no doubt about the digital transformation and the outcome that comes from that, which I will share in the next slide in a few minutes. But before that, you know, the process of getting you in the digital transformation mode is very much about getting things ready. I mean, we see all over the place organizations that could not work from home because they have documents in the office, they have papers that they need to go and do something. They could not do bank transactions, they could not do employee transaction, they could not fulfill orders, they could not receive payment, they could not prepare payments, simply because their processes are depending on paper. Not only because the companies are like that, but because the infrastructure is like that. There might be rules and regulations locally that we have to follow that are paper-based. So fixing the past would basically allow you to, at least on your own side, whether you are a public sector organization, you are a school, or you are a business, transform yourself by using technology, starting by digitizing your workflows, starting by digitizing your documents, making yourself as independent on the analog world as possible. Then take that to the next step and focus on the present. What are the things we can improve now? And things like, for example, e-signature is something that suddenly has been you know, accepted very widely because of the need. The need is higher than the perceived risk of digital. So we had this notion in our region. When I said our region, I'm talking about APAC, and some countries have been very forward in terms of you know, using technology for digital banking and stuff. But at the end of the day, many, many countries in this region demand you to bring a piece of paper to do your transaction. And also consumers, I mean, I have friends who have still a bank book, you know, the passbook that they go and check in the bank if there's any updates on anybody receiving a payment and so on. So it's not only what we call the boomers, which is basically my age and older, who are like this. There are still a lot of people in our society that are not ready for this digital transformation. So focusing on the present basically allow you to transform some of these processes into a digital process, which leads you to the digital transformation, and the digital transformation then creates an outcome. If we look at the next slide, you will be able to see where the digital transformation basically creates a value on three different areas. So the strategy that you have to build will be around the system of intelligence. So the value creation, the customer satisfaction, and the business continuity, this is the purpose of the digital transformation. So how can we use digital transformation to create a system of intelligence that allow us better customer experience, customers is external customer, internal customer, citizens, it's how we transact. How do we make sure that when these situations happen, that our business can continue on its own on a remote control? You know, as a tech company, we have been able to do that mostly. You know, we can deliver. We have delivered, as I said, more than 1,000 organizations. We have delivered services in this past 3 months from home. Our people have been working from home. We have had nobody in the office. In fact, we have to change all of our you know, plans because there was nobody to go to the office to water the plants even. So we have been able to still deliver a government have gone online with our solutions in one country, having the parliament online without us going there. So this is the kind of future we are talking about, present or future we are talking about. And that's what we are discussing today.